else. You can have an amazing career. You can have the amazing career. You can have the most money. You can have all of these things. But if you're not growing as a person, if you can't look at yourself and consider yourself a good person, and you can't be satisfied with yourself, what are you really?
That, like, mentally, the slavery is not physical anymore. It's mental. As far as the New World Order has come in the shape of electronics. You know what I'm saying? Taking away your mind from what you want to apply it to. The mind is but a magnet to what you want. You know what I'm saying? The law of attraction, like all the laws of the universe. I studied all the laws of the universe.
Not to repeat myself, it's better to be respected through love rather than fear. Simply because, like, all right, I was respected through fear, and it's not real love. It's not real love, and it drives people away. It makes people treat you differently. It makes people really, like, it's just not genuine. It's not what you really would want. So
don't look at everything else as the problem. Look at yourself and see how you can change yourself to where nothing bothers you, to where you're unbothered about a lot of things, and to where life doesn't exactly affect you in that manner. It's changing your perception that kind of changes the world around you, because it's the small things that we don't appreciate. So in order to appreciate everything, you have to be very, very, very analytical. So in being analytical, you start to observe the world in a different manner. So even how you approach people, even how you move, even how you think, and you change the way you think, you change the way you perceive the world.
In itself, the whole point is evolution and creation. If you're not evolving, you're doing something wrong. So anything that takes away the power of your mind is keeping you still and delaying your evolution. The whole point of life is evolution. Study your laws of the universe. The law of attraction, the law of abundance, the law of equivalent exchange. Study your laws, the laws of cause and effect, the karmic cycle. Study your laws. Dwell into your mind, meditate.
And let them do it, you get me? Mm-hmm. I'm the type of person where if I'm gonna lead someone, or I'm gonna do this shit and people idolize me, I'm gonna lead them in the right direction, you feel me? I'm not trying to be a fucking prick, right. You get me?
Any so my thing is, and any negativity sent my way is being transmuted to positive energy. So any attention that's being sent my way, I wanna let you guys know that I will only entertain it from a positive perspective. And that's just in general with anything. And you can take this and you can subject it to anything you would like to, because obviously if energy is gonna be sent my way anyways, my goal is to always transmute it. Take that energy and transmute it towards my compassion and my loyalty and my love from my support base as a whole, and just even put it into your lives as well to feel good.
You need to increase your self-love. You need to increase the amount of time that you spend with yourself. Get off of the cell phone. Get off the fucking internet. Be a person and learn how to love yourself. So that way we can end this cycle of destruction. We can end this cycle of hate, and we can start experiencing more love. And there will be more, there will be more love in the streets, more genuine love, more genuine care for people. You can't care for someone if you don't love yourself.
No one can explain why you are alive. No one can save you but you. You have to put the mind into what you want to put the mind into. If you believe in something, you can achieve it. Now, that doesn't mean everybody needs to be a rapper. That does not mean everybody needs to be a fucking painter or an artist. That doesn't mean that way. Your art can be in your emotion. Your art can be in your mind. Now, you can be a doctor, and that can be a form of art. You can be a therapist, and that can be a form of art. It's how you articulate. You get it? Articulate.
How long are we going to sit aside and let them murder our prophets? How long are we going to sit aside? Like, you have these people that arise and come out of nowhere, and our teachers, and our people that are supposed to lead and push people in the right direction with energy.
These are like the people. Like, you're a teacher, the leader?
Of the youth, yes. Of the youth, because they are the ones that can be molded. I have to be very careful with my message. All I want is for people to be able to be themselves, to be free-minded, to ideally understand themselves more, and to unlock that piece of their mind that gives them clarity, that gives them ground. You understand?
Understand that you can alter your realms by your train of thought. The minute you slow down your thought, you're able to leave your body through astral projection. You're only enslaved if you can't control your mind. So while you can, and while you don't have the whole world against you, or you don't have a lot of worries, worry on freeing your mind from this realm. When you can free your mind from this realm, everything is but a thought. And if you can't free your mind, then you're a slave to this room.
There is no such thing. No one can tell you who to be. So in purpose, you have to create your own purpose. And in evolution, you have to evolute towards that purpose. It's easier to live when you have goals to meet. You understand? If you have goals to meet, then you don't feel so voided, and you understand why every day you're looking at this person in the mirror, because that is the cool part about the game. You get to be anybody you want to be. Now, take that, please, and I hope the little words that I did say did motivate you. And I'm sorry if I didn't give you any sort of clarity. I was scatterbrained. Like I said, I winged this. I just simply wanted to speak to you guys.